Welcome, here we are again with another Flutter Mentor video. Super simple UI today, literally just a container with a child that will be an image, but the entire point of this video is this file right here, the Pubspec.yaml. This is a file that you will have to make edits to quite often in your Flutter projects, because anytime you add a dependency to the project, you're gonna have to come here. So it's crucial that you understand it. Now, at the first glance, you'll probably come to this file and you're like, this is really confusing. So much text, green, orange, what the hell is going on here? Well, it's actually not that complicated. You see, the green text is commentary, that's it. So if you look at it from that perspective now, you see that there's not really that much to understand here. And the reason why the comments have a hashtag symbol is because this is written in YAML. If I come over here and I do the classic to sidebars, it doesn't work. This is how you comment on YAML. And if you're wondering what YAML stands for, it stands for YAML Ain't Markup Language. YAML is meant to be a very human-readable language that machines can also understand, to interpret how you want to configure certain things, just like our Flutter projects, for example. Now, simply for explanation's sake, I'm going to delete all the comments that are here, just so everything can be cleaner, making it easier for you to understand my explanation. There. This is what the pubspec.yaml looks like without any comments whatsoever. You just have the names, the description, the version. It's really not too much information. And most of the times you're going to come here and you're going to handle the dependencies. There may be some unique cases with specific packages that you might have to use these dependencies, but you're usually just going to use these ones right here. And I advise you to always look for the Cupertino icon's dependency and then just add the new dependency underneath it. And for example, if you want to add a package here, I already have the text ready here. All you got to do is add this dependency here right underneath Cupertino icons, or you know, if you had another one, you'd add it under this one or this one, and so on. And if you're confused, the packages come from this website, pub.dev. You just come to the installing tab of the package and the dependency is right here. You just copy this text right here and then you place it here. After this, you do pub get and things happen automatically and everything's done. As simple as that when it comes to adding an external package. Now, let's say you want to add an image. And this is exactly why I said that the commentary can be very helpful, because it's much easier to just edit what's commented and turn it into YAML code. So let's get back to the original file. Here it is. This is what you're going to be seeing every time you come in file for the first time. And as you can see, the dependency is here underneath Cupertino icons, which if you don't know is the Apple icons dependency. Now let's add an image asset, shall we? First thing you need to do is go to your project folder and create a new directory. I'm going to call it assets, but you can call it whatever you want. Then you take your image and you drag it over there. Refactor, and it's done. This is just my phone screensaver, and I'm just gonna change the names so it's simpler. And now what you would do is come here and just remove the comments. So let's remove it. And now the next thing you need to understand is that for YAML, each indentation level equals to 2 spacebar spaces. And in this case, this is the main property here, and you can see the path underneath here. Whatever comes after it belongs to this section. And as you can see, uses material design, and again, I'm selecting it, and so this updates, okay? This is the path that I'm at right now. And this can sometimes be a good indicator of whether things are going well or not. But what we're talking about here is assets. And if you notice, if I click here, it does say images spinach.jpg. But if I click here, it doesn't update it because this is clearly wrong on the indentation level. You would have to do this, and now it did update. If I click here, it will be right here. Now, this seems like it could work, but I don't think it will because the indentation level is not the same. And you should always make sure the indentation level is exactly the same. And since we've changed this one, let's confirm that everything is right here. And it is. 2 spaces, as you can see. There are 2 spaces until there. And that's how everything works here. And it's not images, it's assets, and it's not spinach, it's image 1. And this one does not exist. And now I'll click away and you can see that everything looks good. Everything's aligned and correctly indented. As you can see, 1, 2 and 1, 2, okay? That's how this works. After you've done any changes to this file, you have to run pub get. It takes a second and you're good to go. Sometimes this will show up, just click get dependencies. And now let's get the image on the app. Let's get rid of this widget here and add the image. Image.asset, then you place the path to the file as a string. Let me just confirm that's correct. It is. So I just ran into an error. You probably saw how much of a dumbass I am. Here it is, .png. Very simple mistake, but learn from me and don't do something stupid like this. Now let's really go for it, as this should actually work this time. Just save, and there it is. The image we imported is now on our app. And if you want to put the package I added into action, it's super easy. Let's do it now. Change this to a text widget, give it an ID variable, import the package first. That is a must every time. And now this is how you use the package. Oops, let me remove the dollar sign because that's only meant to be used inside a string when you're doing string concatenation, which you can click the video suggestion that's showing up on the top right screen. Now, if I save this, there's an ID, a very unique ID. And that's pretty much what this app does. If I save this again, it's a different ID. I already have a video on this. So this is everything for today. I hope you learned what this file here does. And I hope it's not as scary as it was before you watched this video. And if you did learn something, then please don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel if you want to keep on learning Flutter. Now, without anything else to add, this is Flutter Mentor, and out.